today I'll be explaining the first Viking conquest. So first, who were the Vikings? Viking is the term for the people who came from Scandinavia. So Scandinavia is people who came from Denmark, Norway and Sweden. So do you guys know why Vikings actually venturing out from their homeland? Anybody knows? Okay, another answer? Izai, how about you, Izai? What do you think? Why are the Vikings venturing out from their homeland? Louder, please. Spend their conquest. At the back, Azri? why do you think Vikings venturing out from their homeland? Is that why they go out from their homeland?
Explore the world.
Explore the world, okay. Same answer, right? Okay, so Vikings actually venturing out from their homeland. Some have suggested that it was due to overpopulation of their homeland. And the earliest Vikings were searching for riches. And not land. Vikings are more known as the Norse or Norsemen between 8th and 11th centuries. So next, the Viking timeline. On 789, the Vikings begin their attacks on England. A Viking force landed at Scotland, Dorset. So at this time, there was a local reeve who went to meet the Viking, but then he was killed. So from that, a force that got blown with that Viking attacks is increased in intensity over the coming decades. On 793, Viking attacks the monastery of Lindisfarne. So do you guys know what is monastery?
Yes.
No one knows? No? Irfan, do you know Irfan? Okay. Monastery is actually a building occupied by a community of monks. So Viking attacked the monastery of Lindisfarne and they killed a large number of monks and took other estates. An Anglo-Saxon scholar wrote that an Anglo-Saxon scholar, after he heard about the attacks, he wrote that never before has such an atrocity been seen. Means that he says what he was meant to say is it was God's punishment on the kingdom for its fornication, adultery, incest, and greed. So that's why the Viking attacks the monastery. On 795, Viking attacked the island monastery of Iona, Scotland, and they attacked Iona again on 802, and the third attack in 806, 68 monks were killed, some fled to safety in the monastery of Kells. So on the third attack, it's like there's so many monks were killed, so other monks led to monastery of Kells. On 800, Osberg Viking longship is buried about this time. So this is the picture of the Osberg Viking longship. So along with the longship, there's two women with red hoods buried. Do you understand? Along with the longship, there were two women and the grave goods. Means grave goods. Okay, buried. Okay. Next, 840, Viking settlers found the city of Dublin Island. In 844, a Viking force attacked Spain, but then they were defeated. Okay, so why they were defeated? Why? Anybody knows? No. Okay. So they were defeated because Emir Abdul Ar-Rahman II of Cordoba sent a large force against the Vikings under the command of Haji, the chief minister of Cordoba. So that is why the Vikings were defeated in Spain. You guys understand? Right? Okay, in 860, Rus Viking attacked Constantinople, Istanbul. So, Rus Viking is actually the Vikings who crossed the Baltic Sea, descended across Eastern Europe. There were many types of Vikings. So, Rus Viking is one of the Vikings. So they attacked Constantinople, Istanbul, and they actually launched a surprise attack. At a time when the city was left largely undefended, they came to attack Istanbul. Yeah, they won. Because at that time, the armies between Emperor Michael III and Abbasid Caliphate are fighting. When the Viking came, so that's why the city was left undefended because the armies are fighting between them. Do you understand, Zali? And everybody else. Okay. On 862, Novgorod in Russia is founded by the Rus Viking Rish. Okay. 866, Ivar and the Great Heathen marched north and invaded Northumbria. Northumbria. And on November 1, the Danish Vikings in England took Jorvik, or known as York, and used it as base to make raids into Mercia. Okay, so on 871, King Alfred of Wessex died from injuries sustained in the Battle of Marathon. So actually, the Battle of Marathon is between King Alfred, along with his brother, and they fought against the Danes. You know the Danes? The Danes is also one of the Vikings, the Danish Vikings. Okay, so because of his sons were considered too young to succeed, and Alfred's younger brother, the one who fought along with him, is now in the Battle of Marathon, Alfred become king. Alfred. In 872, Harald I, known as Fairhair, became king of Norway. And in 879, Rurik establishes Kiev as the center of Kievan Rus domain. Rurik is also the Vikings. Kiev is located in, who knows, where is Kiev located? Faris, do you know, Faris? Where is Kiev located? Okay, Kiev is located in Ukraine. Okay, in 886, Alfred divides England with the Danes under the Danelaw Pact. Okay, so during the 886, Alfred, who is the king of Wessex, retaken London and brought the Vikings under King Guthrum to terms, means that they want to make an agreement. Alfred and due to the agreement, Alfred and Wessex retained the west, while east is the Viking territory. You guys understand? Alfred retaken London and brought the Vikings along under King Guthrum to make an agreement. So based on the agreement, Alfred and the Wessex retained the West. So they got the west, while the Viking, they got the east. Okay, so you guys understand? Did you, are you okay? So then Lopak is where English, people, which is Alfred and Alexis, and the Vikings, the Danish Vikings, were equal in law. Okay? So in 900, the Vikings raid along the Mediterranean coast. Sorry. And also the Viking ship Rollo is rented land by the Franks and found a ring in France. Okay. The Viking Rollo was given a land in north of France by the French king, which is Charles the Simple, which is now become known as the land of Northmen or Normandy. In 941, Rus Vikings again attacked Constantinople, Istanbul. And lastly, on 981, Viking leader Eric the Red discovers Greenland. So do you guys understand the timeline? Okay, so I think that's all from me. So I'll pass the next slide to Maddie.
So hello, hi. My name is Nurmani Hamidi Mamat Sabri. So today I'm going to continue with the second Viking conquest. Okay, this is the timeline for the second Viking conquest. It began with year 986 AD until 1066 AD. So let's begin. Okay, in year 986 AD, the Viking ship sailed in Newfoundland. Newfoundland is a province of Canada, and here is an example of the Viking ships. Next. Okay, in year 991 AD, Ethelred II, which is also known as the Unready, was the king of England from year 978 to 1013, and again from year 1014 until his death. Ethelred II is the first one to pay the first Danegeld ransom to stop Danish from attacking England. Okay, Danegeld ransom was raised to pay tribute to the Viking riders to save a land from being ravaged. Next. Okay, here is a picture of Ethelred II. Next. Okay, in 995 AD, Olaf I, who is a king of Norway from year 995 to 1000 AD, conquered Norway and proclaimed it as a Christian kingdom. Okay, in 1000 AD, Christianity reached Greenland and also Iceland. And Leif Erikson, who is the son of the Eric the Red, explored the coast of North America. And then Olaf I died, and Norway is now ruled by the Danes. Okay, this is a picture of Leif Erikson. Okay, in year 1002 AD, Brian Boru defeats the Norse. The Norse were a people of mixed Gaelic and also Norse ancestry and culture. And when Brian Boru managed to defeat the Norse, he then became the king of Ireland. Okay, in 1010 AD, the Viking explorer who is Thorfinn Karlsefni, an Icelandic-born Scandinavian leader of an early colonization expedition to North America. The explorer, who is a Thorfinn Karlsefni, he attempted to found a settlement in North America. Okay, in year 1013 AD, the Danes conquer England, and after that flees to Normandy. Okay, the Danes is are a North Germanic ethnic group native to the Denmark. In 1015 AD, the Viking added the Vinland settlements on the coast of North America. In 1016 AD, Olaf II regains Norway from the Danes. You know what is the Danes, right? Okay. The Danes under Canute, who is the king of England and Denmark, then conquered Norway. In year 1028 AD, Knut, King of England and also Denmark, conquered Norway. In year 1042 AD, Edward the Confessor, who is also known as Saint Edward the Confessor, and Edward the Confessor is also the son of the Ethelred the Unready. Edward the Confessor ruled England with the support of the Danes. Okay, in year 1050 AD, the city of the Oslo is founded in Norway. And the last one is 1066 AD. This is the end of the second Viking conquest. Harald Godwinson, who is the king of the England, defeats Harald Hardrada, who is the king of Norway, at the Battle of the Stamford Bridge. And William, who is Duke of Normandy, defeats the Saxon king, Harold, at the Battle of Hastings. Next. Okay, this is Harald Godwinson, and this is Harald Hardrada. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you. Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Peanut butter and
jelly.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Papa.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Where are you?
What else? Hotel. Bingardium. Okay, my name is Kamala Nikita Hardy. I'm from Belmondi, and I will be presenting about. Okay, I will be presenting about English. Scandinavians become English. So, is English a Scandinavian language? Okay, first of all, how do you pronounce this word?
Scandinavian.
One more time. Okay, that is actually the correct pronunciation. Please don't pronounce this as Scandinavian, because I've heard quite a lot of people pronounce it as Scandinavian. Not Scandinavian, it's Scandinavian. Can you repeat after me? Scandinavian.
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 Okay, not Scandinavian. Okay, I know it's quite tricky because Scandinavian seems quite a lot easier to pronounce and it sounds quite familiar, but please don't do this mistake in tests or exams, okay? Okay, Scandinavia. It is actually a region in Northern Europe. In local usage, it covers Denmark, Norway and Sweden. But in English usage, it also covers the Scandinavian peninsula, including Finland and Iceland. So this is the map that covers the term Scandinavia. This is Norway, this is Denmark, and Sweden. These three are the major countries that made up the term Scandinavia. And also it covers Iceland and Finland. So basically all of this is Scandinavia. Okay, is the root of modern English really lies in the West German language? Is English a form of Western Germanic or Scandinavian?
From what we have learned before, for the past weeks, we all know that modern English came from Old English and then Middle English, and we know that Old English groups with West Germanic language. But do you really think so? There is actually a theory. This is quite different with what we have learned before, so I want you to clear up your mind for just for a while. Okay, next. Okay. Can you see at the back? Can you read it?
Yes.
The British have borrowed. It is popular belief. The popular belief is that the British have borrowed words and concepts from the Norwegian and Danish Vikings and their descendants. As you all know, Norwegian and Danish are from Norway and Denmark, which is actually from the North Germany. But contrary to this popular belief, Nicholson in 2012 stated that they did not just borrow words and concepts, but he stated that what we call English now, modern English, is actually a form of Scandinavian. So, two researchers from Oslo University started a research, and they believe that they can prove that English belongs to North Germanic group, which is from Scandinavia. And this is actually clashes to what the rest of the world believe, that modern English was directly from Old English. Next. Okay, so Professor Joseph Emmons from Palakir University in the Czech Republic and Jean-Serge Farland from University of Oslo started this research. This is the research paper, the cover page only. The research paper of what they propose, the theory that English is actually a Scandinavian language. English, the language of Vikings, Joseph M. B. Emmons and Jean-Serge Farland. This is their research paper in 2014. Okay, Farland says, quote, modern English is a direct descendant of the language of Scandinavians, who settled in the British Isles in the course of many centuries before the French-speaking Normans conquered the country in 1066. This one, 2004. We have learned that the Vikings have raided British before this, right? So they came to British Isles because of overpopulation, they wanted to... Oh, okay. Next, Farland also stated that Old English and Modern English are actually two very different languages. Quote, we believe it is because Old English quite simply died out while Scandinavian survived, albeit strongly influenced, of course, by Old English. We will get to this after this, okay? So let's go to the chronology of how the Scandinavians settled in British Isles. First, so the Scandinavians or the Vikings came to Britain. They settled in British Isles, so the cohabitation between the British and the Scandinavians was largely hostile. Cohabitation is basically the relationship between Scandinavians and British people. They were not unfriendly, because who loves someone coming to your place and do whatever they like, right? Yes. So the Scandinavians found no reason to switch to the language of the country they had arrived in. They didn't want to switch from Scandinavian language to Old English language. They did not want that. Okay, so the language